think that this is one of the largest animals on this planet.
In 2007, an oil rig worker glanced at a monitor and saw something that made him call over his colleagues. 15,000 feet below the surface, floating in the abyss, was a creature that shouldn't exist, with arms longer than a giraffe is tall, bent at impossible angles like broken spider legs. Scientists had never seen anything like it, and the deeper we go, the stranger they become. What you're about to discover will make you question if Earth is truly our planet, or theirs. We've mapped Mars, we've photographed distant galaxies, but over 80% of our own ocean remains unexplored. And when we do send cameras into the deep, what comes back defies explanation. Transparent skulls, jaws that unhinge like nightmares, bodies that glow in colors that shouldn't exist. There's a reason deep sea creatures look like they're from another world. And by the end of this video, you'll understand the terrifying physics that created them. But first, we need to talk about that creature from the oil rig, because it's exactly where our journey begins. The creature on that monitor was a bigfin squid, and everything about it is wrong. Most squids have 8 arms and 2 longer tentacles, easy to tell apart. But the bigfin? All 10 appendages look identical. They hang straight down from its body, stretching up to 20 feet long, 20 times the length of its actual body. Imagine if your arms hung down to your knees, then kept going for another 30 feet. And here's where it gets creepier. Those arms bend at sharp angles, creating what look like elbows. Scientists still can't explain why. Some think it prevents tangling. Others believe it's a hunting adaptation we don't understand yet. Because we barely understand these creatures at all. Since bigfin squids were officially identified in 2001, there have been fewer than 20 confirmed sightings. They live deeper than almost any other squid. The deepest ever recorded was at 20,381 feet in the Hadal zone. That's deeper than the deepest diving whale, deeper than most submarines can reach. The footage is always unsettling. The squid drifts motionless in pitch darkness, arms dangling below like a trap. Scientists believe those tentacles are covered in microscopic sticky suckers, and the squid just waits. Prey bumps into the net of arms, gets stuck, and it's over. It's a hunting strategy we've never seen anywhere else on Earth. A creature that looks like it's from an alien planet, using physics and biology in ways we're only beginning to understand. And the bigfin squid isn't even close to the strangest thing down there. Because as we descend deeper into the ocean, past the last traces of sunlight, the rules of biology start to break. The creatures we find aren't just adapted to the deep, they're fundamentally redesigned by it. Here's what you need to understand. The deeper you go, the more everything changes. At the surface, you experience 1 atmosphere of pressure. That's 14.7 pounds per square inch. Comfortable. Normal. But for every 33 feet you descend, another atmosphere is added. At 1,000 feet, the pressure is 30 times greater than the surface. At 3,000 feet, it's 91 times. And at the deepest point in the ocean, the Mariana Trench, nearly 36,000 feet down, the pressure reaches over 1,000 atmospheres. That's the equivalent of 50 jumbo jets stacked on top of your body. If you were teleported there, your lungs would collapse instantly. Your bones would crack. Air pockets in your body would compress until you were crushed into something unrecognizable. And yet creatures live there, not just survive, thrive. How? Because they've eliminated the one thing that makes pressure deadly: air. Humans have lungs, sinuses, ears, air-filled spaces that compress catastrophically under pressure. Deep sea creatures don't have that problem. Many have no swim bladders, no air pockets at all. They're made mostly of water and soft tissue. And water, unlike air, doesn't compress. Their bodies are like living stress balls. When pressure increases, they simply flex, deform slightly, but never break. Their skeletons aren't rigid bone, they're flexible cartilage. Their skin isn't firm, it's gelatinous, almost jelly-like, pull a deep sea fish to the surface and it looks like it's melting. That's because without the crushing pressure holding it together, there's nothing to maintain its shape. But the adaptations go deeper than that. Literally, at the cellular level. Deep sea organisms have specialized molecules in their cells called TMAO, trimethylamine N-oxide. Under pressure, proteins in cells would normally stop functioning, like butter solidifying in a refrigerator. TMAO prevents that, keeping proteins flexible and operational even under 1,000 atmospheres. Interestingly, TMAO is also what gives fish their fishy smell. So if you've ever wondered why fish smell that way, it's because they're packed with the same molecule that lets their cousins survive in the deepest trenches on Earth. But surviving pressure is just the beginning, because the deep sea has stripped away something far more fundamental, light. Below 3,300 feet, the midnight zone, no sunlight penetrates, ever. It's not dim, it's not twilight, it's absolute perfect blackness. And when you remove light, evolution gets creative in terrifying ways. Some creatures go invisible. The glass squid, the glass octopus, their bodies are completely transparent. You can see their internal organs suspended in clear jelly. It's camouflage in the faintest light. No shadow, no silhouette, nothing for predators to detect. Others do the opposite. They create their own light. Nearly 90% of deep sea creatures are bioluminescent. They glow, but not for beauty, for survival. Take the dragonfish. It produces red bioluminescence, a color almost no other deep sea creature can see. To most eyes down there, red light is completely invisible. So the dragonfish has evolved a private spotlight. It illuminates prey without giving itself away, a secret wavelength only it can detect. It's like having night vision goggles in a world where everyone else is blind. Then, there's counter-illumination, one of the most brilliant adaptations in nature. From below, predators can spot dark silhouettes against the faint shimmer of light from above. So creatures like the firefly squid cover their bellies with bioluminescent organs. They adjust the brightness to match the glow from the surface, erasing their outline entirely. They make light disappear into light. But perhaps the most disturbing use of light belongs to the anglerfish. Anglerfish dangle a glowing lure in front of their mouths, drawing in prey. Their jaws are enormous, unhinged, capable of swallowing prey larger than themselves. But their reproduction strategy is even more nightmarish. Male anglerfish are born tiny, weak, and essentially useless. Their only purpose is to find a female, a nearly impossible task in the infinite darkness. When a male finally locates one, he latches onto her body with specialized jaws. Then, he fuses into her. His organs dissolve, his body withers away until he's nothing but a sack of sperm, permanently attached, nourished by her blood. He becomes a living parasite. Or perhaps, from evolution's perspective, a permanent mating partner. Either way, it's one of the most extreme reproductive strategies known to science. And the anglerfish isn't even the most disturbing creature down there. In 2020, scientists discovered something in the Philippine trench that shouldn't be possible. A fish, swimming at pressures no fish should survive, over 27,000 feet down, in the Hadal zone, named after Hades, the Greek underworld. The snailfish, fragile, translucent, with gelatinous skin and no scales. It looks too delicate to exist anywhere, let alone in one of the most extreme environments on Earth. Yet, it's the deepest living vertebrate ever discovered. Its cells are packed with TMAO. Its bones are barely calcified, just soft cartilage. Its entire body is designed to endure pressures that would obliterate almost any other creature. But the truly unsettling part, scientists believe there's a depth limit for all fish, a point where even TMAO can't protect cellular structures from fundamental compression. That limit is around 27,000 feet. The snailfish lives right at the edge of what biology allows. Then there's the gulper eel, a creature that looks like someone stretched a fish until it broke. Its mouth is enormous, hinged to open wider than its entire body. It can swallow prey larger than itself whole. Its stomach expands like a balloon. When scientists first saw footage of it, they thought the camera was malfunctioning. Nothing should be shaped like that. Or consider the barrel-eye fish. It has a transparent skull. Yes, transparent. You can see its brain, its eyes, everything. And those eyes, they don't point forward. They point straight up, inside its head, constantly scanning the darkness above for prey silhouettes. When it wants to eat, the eyes rotate forward. It's a fish with a transparent skull and movable eyes encased inside it. Every single one of these adaptations arose from the same source: extreme pressure, zero light, and almost no food. But perhaps the most unsettling phenomenon in the deep sea is this. Things get bigger. The giant isopod, a deep sea relative of the pill bug you find in your garden, grows to the size of a small dog, up to 16 inches long, with a hard exoskeleton and compound eyes. The Japanese spider crab has a leg span of up to 12 feet. It's the largest arthropod alive, skittering across the ocean floor on legs longer than most humans at all. And then there's the colossal squid. Not the giant squid. The colossal squid is even larger. It can grow to 46 feet long with eyes the size of dinner plates. It has rotating hooks on its tentacles, not just suckers, hooks, to latch onto prey and rip into flesh. Scientists call this phenomenon deep sea gigantism, but they still don't fully understand why it happens. Some theories suggest it's about conserving energy. Larger bodies retain heat better in the freezing deep. Others think it provides defense in an environment where predators are scarce. Still others believe it's related to the abundance of food. When a whale carcass falls to the ocean floor, it feeds entire ecosystems for decades. Creatures that can grow large have an advantage in consuming as much as possible when food arrives. But here's the disturbing reality. We don't really know. We've barely scratched the surface of understanding these ecosystems. Every submersible dive brings back creatures never before seen by science. Translucent fish, glowing worms, jellies that break every rule of biology. In 2012, filmmaker James Cameron descended to the deepest point on Earth, the Challenger Deep in the Mariana Trench, nearly 7 miles below the surface. When he reached the bottom, he described it as a lunar landscape. Barren, alien, lifeless. Except it wasn't. Even there, at the absolute limit of depth, life exists. Amphipods the size of your hand scuttle across the sediment. Snailfish drift through the darkness. Microbes colonize every grain of mud. And here's the unsettling part. When scientists examined those amphipods, they found something inside them. Plastic. Microplastic fibers that had drifted down from the surface. The most remote, unexplored habitat on Earth. And we've already contaminated it. But contamination isn't the only threat. Deep sea mining is ramping up. Companies want to extract rare minerals from the ocean floor. The problem? We don't even know what lives down there yet. We're about to disrupt ecosystems we haven't discovered. And those ecosystems might hold answers to some of the biggest questions in science. Life at hydrothermal vents, volcanic fissures on the ocean floor, doesn't rely on sunlight at all. It's based entirely on chemosynthesis. Microbes feed on chemicals spewing from the Earth's crust. Hydrogen sulfide, methane, superheated minerals. Entire communities of worms, clams, and crabs survive on this chemistry. It's a food web that functions without the sun, a completely independent form of life. And it raises a profound question. If life can exist like this in Earth's oceans, could it exist on other worlds? Icy moons like Europa and Enceladus have liquid oceans beneath their frozen surfaces. No sunlight reaches them, but they have hydrothermal activity. Studying the deep sea isn't just about understanding Earth. It's about understanding the possibilities of life itself. So why do deep sea creatures get creepier the deeper you go? Because the conditions get more extreme with every meter. More pressure, less light, less food, less oxygen. Evolution doesn't care about aesthetics. It cares about survival. And when you're designing life for the most hostile environment on Earth, you end up with creatures that look like nightmares. Bigfin squids with spider legs dangling in the void. anglerfish with parasitic males fused to their bodies, snailfish living at the edge of what biology allows, creatures with transparent skulls, unhinged jaws, and bodies that glow in the dark. They're not monsters. They're masterpieces of adaptation, proof that life will find a way, no matter how extreme the conditions. But here's what should terrify you. We've explored less than 5% of the ocean. For every creature we've documented, there could be dozens, hundreds, we haven't seen yet. The bigfin squid wasn't discovered until 2001. The colossal squid wasn't confirmed until 2007. Every year, we find new species that rewrite what we thought was possible. So the next time you look at the ocean, remember, you're not looking at Earth's surface. You're looking at the roof of the largest habitat on the planet. And beneath that roof, in the crushing darkness, things are swimming that we can't even imagine yet. If this video made you question everything you knew about life on Earth, hit that like button and subscribe. Drop a comment. Which deep sea creature creeps you out the most? Because the abyss isn't just a place, it's a reminder. A reminder that our planet still holds secrets. That life is stranger, more resilient, and more terrifying than we ever imagined. Thanks for watching. And remember, right now, as you're sitting here, a bigfin squid is drifting in the darkness with its 20-foot arms spread wide. A snailfish is enduring pressures that would crush you instantly. An anglerfish is waiting with its glowing lure. They've been down there for millions of years. They'll be there long after we're gone. The deep sea doesn't care if we understand it. It just keeps creating nightmares.